friends! Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Lindsay, and in today's video, we're gonna do a deep dive on the hottest new design trend for 2021, a word you may not have even heard of yet, Japandi. Have you been gravitating toward all the warm-toned rooms with minimalist yet cozy vibes? Well, then this is the video for you. Let's get into it. Recently, I made a couple of videos on interior design trends for 2021 and trends that need to go in 2021, and it was very clear that a lot of you are interested in pursuing the Japandi style. Japandi is the blend of Japanese Zen minimalism and Scandinavian Hygge. It creates a cozy yet simplistic living space that is popping up in rooms and Instagram feeds all over the world. Searches for Japandi were up 100% in the last year, and it's very clear to see why. Japandi is the best of both styles. It is modern, functional, open spaces, clean, warm, casual, universally appealing. In order to best explain this style and help you to identify key elements when you're outsourcing items for your home, first, we've got to go over the two major interior design styles that merge to create Japandi: Scandinavian Hygge and Japanese Zen minimalism. And then we're going to circle back to Japandi and how you can implement these ideas today in your home redesigns. All right, let's get right into it with some Scandinavian design. You've likely heard Scandi thrown around in interior design circles or even as you're scrolling on Instagram or Pinterest for design ideas for your space. Scandinavian comes from, of course, Scandinavian countries, but this is the design style that's influenced design all over the world at this point. It's very popular. It's all about elevating those natural fibers and materials. You're gonna see a lot of light toned woods, warm color palettes, things that will make the place cozy, like a lot of layered pillows, blankets, natural fibers like linen, different textures in a space, but all within a very muted and neutral color palette. Sometimes you'll see pops of color, but generally it's gonna be more for contrast. Think darker tones like black or dark browns, and then very light tones like ivories and whites. Playing with those two things can make a space feel very connected and cohesive, even if there's not a lot of excessive decor or art in the space to bring things together. It's through that contrast in colors that Scandinavian style feels really snap, simple, put together without a lot of superfluous stuff. Think natural materials, warm neutral color palettes, light toned mix of different colors of wood but kind of in the same color story, furniture with modern clean lines, things that have a little bit of a mid-century modern leaning bent to them, or very modern sleek stuff that doesn't even have hardware. Scandinavian lifestyle in general is all about savoring life's pleasures. So when you're finding things to add to a Scandinavian style home, you want to be very purposeful and only bring in things that are either handmade, have some sort of connection to you personally, vintage items. You can even mix styles here by bringing in some vintage oil paintings, for example, juxtaposing that with a very simplistic open space and modern furniture of the Scandinavian aesthetic. Which brings me to Hygge. Hygge is the cornerstone of the Danish way of life. Hygge is more about atmosphere and experience rather than things in a space. And if you're interested in learning more about Hygge, I highly recommend this book. It's called The Little Book of Hygge, Danish Secrets to Happy Living, written by Mike Viking, and he's the CEO of Happiness. Does that not sound like the coolest job ever? At the Research Institute in Copenhagen. And in this book, he goes over in great detail all the different ways to pursue Hygge, that cozy Danish lifestyle vibe, in your own life. And chapter 6 is all about the home. Reading through this is like reading through a list of Scandinavian design elements. The author points out a lot of different things that will make your home more Hygge, including a fireplace or candles, things made out of wood, natural things like real plants, real fibers, real textures, lots of books, ceramic pieces, think tactile things that have texture to them, vintage pieces like light fixtures or furniture, and piles of blankets and cushions to make even the most minimal furniture feel cozy and comfy. According to the Danish, the headquarters of Hygge is in the home, and you can definitely pursue that through some of these design aesthetics. They even recommend creating your own Hygge krog, which is a little cozy nook area for you to sit down with maybe a cup of coffee or a piping hot cup of tea or maybe even a glass of wine and a good book and just kind of snuggle up and enjoy your home. The author says that he set up his in a corner of his home that's surrounded by windows so he could really let in a lot of the natural light, just enjoy the space. Something to consider if you want to add that Scandi vibe into your home. Now that we've gone over the basics of Scandinavian style, it's time to look at the other half of Japandi, Japanese Zen minimalism. This is what people typically think of when they think of minimalism, but there's a lot more to it than just a lack of stuff. Japanese Zen minimalism comes from the traditional Japanese Zen philosophy. It's more than just a design style, it's a lifestyle. Zen strives to clear the space and the mind of excess clutter to achieve true peace and calm. To achieve Zen is to achieve mental freedom. That's a lot easier to achieve if you aren't concerned or distracted by clutter in your space every time you walk into a room. We all want to live a simpler life, right? Well, Japanese Zen minimalism takes simplicity to a whole new level. Designers in this space veer toward the simple over the complex and strive to rid a space of anything unnecessary. Only the essential can stay. Minimalism says that what is needless is excess and therefore waste. Japanese Zen minimalism places great value on the absence of the unnecessary, only leaving space for what is truly essential. Things like superfluous accessories, decor, anything not useful or immediately functional, even excess walls dividing up your living spaces should go if you're trying to pursue true Japanese Zen minimalism. Think about indoor-outdoor living spaces where walls and doors might open to bring the outdoors in. Or if that's not possible, try filling a space with a lot of natural plants, really carefully selecting them for each spot in your home and not going for too many. Think open spaces, greenery everywhere, playful geometry, not only in the aesthetics of your space, but in the furniture you select. Remember, you can also factor in the Japanese idea of wabi-sabi, that there is beauty in imperfection. That means that items that aren't perfect definitely have a space in a Japanese Zen aesthetic. You can also bring in vintage pieces that have meaning and value to you, maybe some things that have an Asian bent, but they don't necessarily have to, as long as they are carefully selected and curated to go for the look that you love. The less you have, the more focus is put on the things you love most. Think simplistic design with artistic elements. Materials, geometry, and nature all have a relationship in the Japanese Zen minimalist style. Now that we've gone over Scandinavian and Japanese Zen, it's time to talk about how they go together to create this whole new style, Japandi. One thing I hope that you understood as I went over both Scandinavian and Japanese style is that these two movements are more than just an interior design style. They're both really products of a lifestyle from different cultures, different places in the world, and really reflect what those places value. What's interesting when you look at Scandinavian and Japanese style is that they share a lot of common traits, which makes it easy to see why the two blend together to create Japandi. Japandi is really a hybrid style. It's the taking of two styles, two separate ideas, separate parts of the world, and really merging them together to create this new aesthetic that so many people are responding to. They both share many of the same underlying principles. It's the perfect blend of form and function. It's decluttered, minimalist spaces, yet a cozy, comfortable, casual vibe, a lived-in space. They both love to embrace and elevate natural materials, so that's a natural jumping-off point for this style. And don't forget to bring the outdoors in through live plants and different ways of accessing balconies or outside spaces through doors that open. Anything that you can do to bring that outside feeling in, whether you're in a large or a very small space. If you're looking to integrate the Japandi style into your home, here's a few tips I've got for you to get started right away. Step one, you might not like to hear this, but it's here for you, declutter. Now, both of these styles definitely put an emphasis on purposeful, curated styling. A space that really reflects the way that you live, the way that you use your space, and only carefully filling your home with purposeful, useful, functional objects. When you're hunting for these things, see if you can find some that are minimalist, that are muted in tone, that have some sort of interesting geometry to them. Think about things that are even everyday objects, like a dish drying rack, for example, or the mugs and glassware that you choose for your home. If you're looking for a new desk chair, can you find one with a really natural wood forward element or some sort of interesting geometry that is going to mesh well with this style. Both Japanese and Scandinavian interior design styles put an emphasis on clean and clutter-free spaces and leave no room for the superfluous and unusable. You can transform any bedroom into the Japandi style by embracing some of these simple design tips. First, focus on natural, light-toned woods through a bed frame, side tables, a bureau, or even a bookcase. Focus on light-toned wood furniture with light-colored upholstery or natural leather. Remember, you're looking for modern, simple lines with a little bit of a nod towards the vintage. Add in that cozy factor with natural materials like linen throw pillows and woolen woven blankets. Feel free to layer on those cozy accessories. The more pillows, the better it's gonna be, my friends. Focus on a warm, neutral color palette, and when adding in pops of color, think again those warm, rich tones like marigolds, rusts, even deep browns can be really satisfying to create some contrast or some elements of black. Natural plants in a variety of sizes, from big planter floor plants to plants hanging from the ceiling even, can create a really outdoors-in vibe that calls to that Japandi aesthetic. And when you're sourcing art pieces, think something super abstract and geometric in those warm color families in some kind of rich or light-toned wood picture frames. It's very minimalist, hanging on the wall with a lot of white space, breathing room around each piece of art. Woven fiber art and texture hanging on the wall can be a great way to do it, but be careful. You don't want to get too far into the boho eclectic vibe if you really want to pursue Japandi. Now let's talk about some ways you can easily transform any living space into that Japandi aesthetic through a couple of simple ideas. First, don't forget to play with light. Sheer curtains are a great way to create some privacy, even if you're living on a main floor apartment, for example, while still letting the light stream into your space. Both Scandinavian and Japanese Zen definitely play a lot with light and put light at the focal point of any room. If you have a dark space, I'm working in a dark space right now, think about integrating in daylight light bulbs. They have a little bit of a cooler tone to them, or even a neutral colored light bulb, one that's not too cool or too warm, will create a brighter, more natural light feeling space, even if your space is naturally darker. You can also look for lighting with dimmers. That's a really great way to kind of control exactly the light that you want in your space to create your desired effect. Remember, when you're designing your living space, you want to pursue the ultimate luxury open space. You want to have some breathing room, some space around furniture pieces. You don't want everything packed and tight together. And that means if you're living in a small space, you might pursue some size appropriate furniture, things that are scaled for a smaller apartment. Don't try to squeeze a giant sofa into a tiny apartment. It's going to throw the whole thing off. If your space is too cluttered with wall-to-wall furniture, you're not going to get that open space feeling, that light and airy feeling that Japandi spaces are known for. So try pursuing items that are more apartment sized if you're living in a small apartment. That way you can have some breathing room around furniture pieces throughout your home. Create flow by pulling furniture out from the walls. Even just a little bit, I promise you, is going to give you the illusion of more space in some cases. Now, of course, if you're in a tiny studio, this might not be as possible, but you know, kind of play it by ear and don't be afraid to pull furniture away from the walls. Remember, that can really create some more space. Another thing you might think about when sourcing furniture in the first place is look for things on legs, because when we can visually see even just a little bit of air flowing underneath a piece of furniture, it instantly makes the whole room feel bigger. You could also go the opposite route and go for super clean and modern, no legs, no knobs, no decoration of any kind, really leaning into the Japanese minimalist side of this trend and focusing on warm wood tones, natural wood tones, nothing painted, very simple. Remember to keep focused on that warm color palette that we've been talking about, so a warm leather sofa or a natural fiber. Add in that cozy factor with natural materials like linen throw pillows and woolen woven blankets. I just have this idea of layering in tons of throw pillows and just like falling into them like a big fluffy couch. It's kind of the thing that would make even the most modern clean line sofa, I'm thinking this one from Article, tons of cozy, cushy, linen, wrinkly, lived-in throw pillows and woven blankets would make it feel, all the coziness in the world. Focus on modern, clean lines when it comes to art and accessories and furniture pieces, natural wood accent furniture, frames, and sculpture. You can even add in some marble, glass, or natural metal finishes. And remember, handmade, antique pieces that you treasure layered in very carefully, maybe through an art piece or a small dish. Think about things that are tactile, that have texture when you hold them in your hand, and just make you feel good when you use them. With Japandi, we're focusing on sustainable items, things that really mean something to you, have value. This is not throwaway decor. This is the kind of thing that you're gonna curate over time and carefully select so that you don't get cluttered. I don't know about you, but I absolutely love learning about new design styles, and I could easily make this a series here on this channel. So if you would like me to break down another interior design style here for you, let me know in the comments which one you would like to see next. This is really the juxtaposition of two design styles that have been around for a very long time. We can trace these back in modern times through the last many decades, and in some cases, thinking about Japanese Zen, we're going back hundreds and hundreds of years. It's interesting to see these new iterations of these popular styles for today's design audience. So start thinking about how you might integrate some of these ideas and Japandi in general into your design aesthetic if this is attractive to you. And like all designs, some things you're gonna like, some things you're not gonna like, that's okay. It's still fun to learn about them, to appreciate them, and to identify the elements when you see them in other homes. I hope you enjoyed this deep dive into the Japandi interior design style and the origin story of this new look in interior design. I'd love for you to comment down below and let me know if you plan to integrate any Japandi style into your home in the near future. Let's brainstorm in the comments, how could we implement some of these styles into our own homes on a budget? If you like this video, do me a favor and hit that thumbs up, subscribe for more interior design and home decor tips. I'm having so much fun sharing ideas here and have new videos coming out every Sunday. Until next time, I challenge you to find one meaningful change you can make in your space this week, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye, my friends.